I'm gonna say 1, 2, 3, and you just scream it out, whether it's hate, rage, abuse, sex trafficking, doesn't matter, man. Just put it out there. You ready? And when we do that, I'm asking, man, Christian, as soon as he can right behind that, we're gonna go into this thing. And when he goes into this song, I don't want you to do the church thing. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. No. How would you respond if you actually believed a chain was broken? See, my neighbor had a dog. His name was Snowball. I kid you not. For 9 years, he kept Snowball on a chain. 9 years, I used to date the girl whose father owned this dog. For 9 years, this dog never got off the chain, Chris. Never. He would watch other dogs walk by the house. He could go so far, but it was like, other dogs would walk by, he would try to follow him and get jerked back. Happened all the time. 9 years. One day, Nathan, the owner of the dog, said, I think I'm gonna let Snowball off the chain today. He had been chained for so long that when he let Snowball off the chain, here's what Snowball did. First, he looked at the chain like, I can't believe it's on. And what he did is he went to where he went as far as he normally could go when he was chained, and he wouldn't go any further. Because in his mind, even though he was free, his mind was chained. And he would go as far as he normally could go. But I'll never forget Nathan getting outside of this, his own perimeter. And he would say, come on, Snowball, come on. And the first time, I'm not making it, this is not a preacher story. The first time Snowball stepped over that line, he stopped and he looked. This is what he did. He looked back at his dog box and he took off running. I kid you not, he never came back. Now that's funny to us. But if a